It's Hot 937, Hartford's number one for hip hop and R&B. This is the Beat of CT. My name is Jenny Boom Boom. DJ Meechie is here with me. What up, Meech?
Morning.
And today we have our friend DJ Hawk from For the Talented Sports with us to give us a little bit of an update of everything they got going on. So, hi, Hawk. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. Cool, so, cool. For the Talented Sports is just thriving. First of all, if you didn't hear our last interview with Hawk, you know, Hawk, can you give us a little bit of a background about For the Talented Sports?
Absolutely. You know, I started the program back in February of 2019. So we're going on our 2-year anniversary next month. And the first year, you know, I started with 14 kids, just, you know, traveling, just trying to get them involved in AAU basketball, give them an opportunity to play basketball year round. And it's now grown, you know, in a 2-year span to where we are serving almost 85 kids, you know, throughout Central Connecticut. We're up to almost 9 basketball teams. And we've added, you know, training year round, AAU basketball year round, you know, shooting, instructional stuff. So, like, we just keep adding more and more stuff. And, you know, the future is very, very bright for us. So
That's awesome. Great. So what made you decide to want to start this nonprofit for the talented?
You know, so my background is social work. Most people don't know, you know, but I've been a social worker since 2004. I have an MSW, a master in social work. And, you know, so that's a part of me, you know, that is very, very dear to my heart, right? Because I love working with kids and just giving opportunities and just being optimistic on changing people's lives and seeing people change and grow, right? But then on the other side, right, there is this passion for basketball, because I always feel like if it wasn't for basketball, I wouldn't have been able to get to where I was. You know, it allowed me an outlet and an avenue for me to be able to get to be able to actually be on radio for 13 years, because if it wasn't for me going to college and playing, I would have never had the opportunity to intern, you know. So it created all of these different opportunities. So I really just wanted to marry the two. You know, that's the reason I started the program. It was, how can I use both of these things that I'm really, really passionate about and bring them together to be able to create opportunity for all of these kids that I see out here that's coming up and kind of struggling and, you know, may not have the opportunity to be able to get showcased, because there's a lot of unbelievable talent in Connecticut, but I just don't think there's a lot of outlets for them to be able to be showcased in the right way, you know. Or the flip side to that is AAU basketball is a money pit, right? And, you know, people try and take advantage of youth sports and they say, hey, give me a kid, I'll just teach them whatever. And the service is very low, but the price is extremely high, right? So we try to, you know, I tried to create something that was really quality and that was just going to marry the two passions that I have in life. And it's strived for me and it has taken off. So thank God, you know?
Right. So, you know, Meechie, I know that you growing up did a lot of sports. I mean, I did as well. Sports are very, very important to children growing up. Hawk, when did you actually start basketball as a kid?
I started playing basketball when I was 11 years old. And, you know, I used to go to school in Farmington, Connecticut, elementary school. And, you know, one of my friends that I used to commute from Hartford every day. And one of my friends, he told me, he was like, yeah, they're having a tryout for travel basketball, so you should come. You know, and he invited me with, listen, I had played around the hood, the milk crates and all of that stuff, right? But I had never, ever played organized basketball. But I had a, you know, they kept me, and probably because I was tall, right? But, you know, I had a coach named Pat Sullivan. He's a real good dude. I actually just reconnected with him. He's actually a lobbyist now in the state of Connecticut. But he took me under his wing, and, you know, he began kind of like grooming me on the basketball level, kind of showing me different skills and teaching me different, you know, skills in life and stuff. And I was like, oh, I really like this, you know, and I was hooked, you know. After a year, I just wanted to get better and better. And I did. And then, you know, I ended up transitioning over to West Hartford, where I was at Connor. And, you know, I did really well. You know, I played varsity all 4 years, you know, and ended up, you know, getting a lot of looks for school. Ended up going to a junior college over at Capital Community, leading the country in scoring, and then transition into Elm up in Chicopee, you know, where I was a junior college All-American, you know. So, you know, I've had a long basketball career, you know. I always tell the kids I've been playing this game over 30 years, you know. So I just love the opportunity to be able to come back and teach it now, you know.
Now, Hawk, like how pivotal is it to have, you know, coming up and you being a kid and having like a mentor, you know, on your side? And then just another question after that is just how, you know, seeing yourself in that position now to be a mentor to your kids. Have you seen any like type of success stories or any changes with some of your kids because of like the impact that you put on them?
So I'm going to answer the second question first, you know, and when we talk about success stories, because that's why we do it, right? Because we love to hear success stories. And I think one of the big success stories is I coach my own kid, you know, and people may not understand how difficult that is, you know, to, you know, we're at a point where I try and limit talking shop inside the car and at home, right? Because it's gotten to like be like really heated discussions at points, you know what I mean? Like, so, you know, like the success story out of that is it's made me a 10 times better father, you know, and has, you know, our relationship has grown so much just because of that connection, right? And we've learned so much more about each other. You know, so I think, you know, we're looking at that. That's a huge success story. And the thing that I want to add to that to answer your first question is I have a ton of fathers that are coaches, you know, and I'm able to now give that information and that experience to them, you know, and help them through the process and see them grow with their kids and see, you know, but so that, you know, that answers your first question. But I think, you know, in the grand scheme of the whole company, you know, I eventually, hopefully this summer, will roll out the mentoring program portion of our company where there is a lot of single parents, right, that sign their kids up to be able to participate in the program. So my objective was to be able to give each kid a mentor. Right. Because that you're right. That's very important. And it helps in a lot of different ways. It helps develop community connections, you know, to people out there, you know, that may be mentors because we invite them to come. Hey, come out and see, you know, this kid that we've connected you with. Come and see them play, you know. So and, you know, it also helps the kid because I try and align it with things they may want to do in life, you know. So like, you know, if you want to be a radio host, hey, Jenny, why don't you come and mentor, you know, Sammy, you know, from New Britain and just, you know, tell him what it's like to be a radio host and what he may be up against and going up in school against, you know, what he needs to focus on in school, what he, you know, help him through this process. You know, now he's connected to somebody that knows it. See, like, that's a piece that I had mentors, but I didn't have mentors so much in radio and things that I really wanted to do passion wise, you know, like I had basketball mentors, but I didn't have a radio mentor. So like, I just think about how easier that connection would have been if I would have been able to have that, you know? So that's a portion of our program that I'm planning to roll out this summer where every kid will be attached to a mentor based upon their passion and what they want to do in life moving forward, you know?
That's so great. You know, and I like about your program too, that the fact that you actually teach it right from the beginning also. I mean, I have five kids. My kids have been in sports since they were little. We're a big sports family, you know, whether it be basketball, soccer, whatever we were doing at the time, but, or baseball, football, but you know, a lot of programs, they pick the best kids and play the best kids where your program actually teaches the kids how to be great.
Yes. That's a great point that you bring up, Jenny, because, you know, every AAU program that I know, definitely in this area, they want the superstar kid, right? And that's not the way I wanted the program to be built around. Like, I wanted my program to be built around, we're going to create the superstar kid. We're going to build and train that kid to be a superstar, you know, like, because when you go out and you look for that superstar kid, you actually isolate and you deter other kids because you make them feel like they're not worthy enough. Right. So we and that's where talented comes from. Like, we believe everybody is talented and everybody has the opportunity to be great. Right. It's just, we just like to introduce putting in the work for them to get to that point. And a lot of people, like most coaches, they want to skip that step and just take a lot of my passion is focused around development, is focused around training. And we start as young as 5-6 years old and getting them to that point, you know?
So, yeah, I mean, I found that so many times, and I think it's really awful because, like you said, it deters the other kids from wanting to really be great. And the way that these kids learn how to be great is by doing it.
Yeah.
And a lot of times they're sitting there, you know, and I don't understand why that is.
It's doing it, and it's being encouraged to do it, being supported around doing it, you know, like. That's where the mentoring comes in. That's where the parental piece come in, you know, because if I got a mom and she's not coming to games, I'm going to go talk to that mom and say, hey, your kid needs you here. They need you here because they need that support. They just want to see your face. You may not know one thing about basketball, but they want to know that you support them through this process and this journey that they're going to take because, yeah, they're not going to have all great days. And yeah, I'm going to be riding their ass a lot, right? But you're going to need that comfort from maybe some, and that nurturing from maybe somebody other than Coach Hawk, right? So it's a very important piece.
You know, I love it. I mean, I don't know, Meech, when you were playing sports, I'm sure your mom was there, mm-hmm. And your family. Our family's that way. I mean, we know that if there's a game or something going on, we are gathering as a family to go support whoever at the time is playing in that game. And it's always been so much fun for our family. I love it.
All right.
You know?
Yeah.
So I know that you have new programs starting. So tell us about those, Hawk.
So one of the programs that we just started top of this year is the shooting instructional. It's called Shoot With Talented. And it's basically, you know, I have invested in this $8,000 machine called the Dr. Dish All-Star. And it basically is a training machine. It basically, you know, this big net goes around the basket and it just keeps kicking the ball back out to you. But I could program it to be able to work on different things specifically that the kid needs to work on, right? So if, you know, to put it in radio terms, if you need to work on transitions, right? Like then I can just program the machine and only thing you will work on that day is transitions. And it keeps data so that, you know, I'm able to see over a period of 6 weeks, the improvement or lack of improvement or what we need to change to be able to get you to, you know, to be where you need to be, right? So, you know, that's a machine that Division I programs and, you know, MBA programs usually have. There's probably a handful of programs in Connecticut that actually has one. But, you know, so that is one of the programs that we kind of rolled out and we do hourly sessions around it. So basically you bring your child in, you know, it's, you know, and how doesn't matter the skill level, advanced or beginner, we'll be able to, you know, work with them on the technique of actually how to hold, shoot the basketball, follow through, shoot at the top of your jump, you know, like we'll be able to look at all of those different things. And it actually has a meter that attaches to be able to keep track of your heart rate while you're shooting, like all of these different things, because you got to be able to, you know, have a like right breathing, be conditioned to be able to, you know, so it's a great machine, and I'm glad I invested in it, and it has just boosted our, the popularity for our program a lot in the last month.
That's awesome. And then you also have like two instructional programs that are happening as well, right?
Yeah. So I have the other piece is called Train with Talented. And you basically, sign your child up. We have it broken up. So, I can do it a la carte, or I could do it, in a bundle for you. I like to, most people say, hey, I'll give you 8 sessions and it's X amount of dollars. And I don't really like to say that. Like, I like to say, okay, let's look and have a conversation about what you want your child to be better at, right? Some people may say, yeah, I just want them to get introduced to the game and start developing fundamental stuff. Okay, I got a package for that. But if you're a more skilled player, I'm not going to be teaching you basic stuff, right? I want to be able to have a conversation with your parent and you and say, hey, what do you need? What do you think your child needs? What do you think they need to develop to be better? Hey, let's talk to your high school coach and let's all have a meeting before we sign up for this and say, hey, what do you think he needs to improve to be a better player next season? Because, all of that stuff is important, and it's all going the extra mile, and it's all things that separate my program from any other AAU program out here. A lot of time I get asked that question, and it's like, we do so much extra. Most AAU programs, they don't care about a mentor. They don't care about like another piece that I'm planning to roll out in the summer is, two things. It's, college prep seminars, and it's financial literacy. I have a financial advisor that works as a coach. So I said, hey, let's tap into that skill. Let's begin teaching kids how to manage their money. Let's work on making all of our kids get a bank account, right? Like teaching them those little things before they get to the college level. So, because I talk to D1 coaches all the time and they're like, Hawk, this kid, he don't even have a bank account, when he stepped on campus, because nobody ever taught him, So we want to begin adding teaching all of those different things as well,
That's amazing that you're even thinking of that, honestly. A lot of folks get in there, they do the job that they feel like they have to do, and they get out. But it just seems like you keep creating great things for these kids. And your programs are so successful, even though COVID-19 is still going on. What is, what's the secret behind your success?
Flexibility. And it's been a little difficult, just because, we've had to navigate through a lot of different obstacles that, yeah, the pandemic is one thing, but the pandemic has also created like all of these other different diversions like that we've had to work around, also. So, and I speak and say like the pandemic is one thing, meaning the sickness, right? And people coming down with the sickness is one thing, but then it's the financial piece, right? It's, navigating the school, it's navigating the schedule, and the travel, right? And the quarantine orders that the governor puts in place. So it's really just, me being flexible and having the flexibility to be able to think outside the box and not only say, well, oh, we got a kid with COVID, let's cancel all the tournaments. like that doesn't make any sense, right? Because now I'm hurting, 80 other kids, I had a kid tell me that he was positive with COVID, and I had, 40 families in New Hampshire already, the day of the tournament, they're in New Hampshire already. Most directors wouldn't have done this, but I pulled the plug on us playing in that tournament until we could do contract tracing, and that's part of the tough things that you have to do as a director, right? Like you, sometimes you do have to do that, but I think, you know, for the most part, it's just been willing to be flexible, is be willing to step outside the box and think about the different tasks that comes before us at that time. Not trying to, you know, think too far ahead, but just looking at how do we navigate what we have in front of us. You know, just recently in November, the governor gave us an order where he told us that you could only have 8 kids on a court at the time. You know, it was really 4 kids on a court, but we have 2 courts in a lot of the places that we rent. So, you know, it was, we've been having to operate on that, you know, so just trying to be flexible, you know.
Yeah, there's a great fear amongst parents like myself to have the kids play sports right now with it being winter and you and being inside, especially. But there's also this great fear if we don't have the kids play sports, you know, what's going to happen to these kids? They're just, you know, it's been very tough. As you know, I don't want to make this about me, but it's been very tough in my family right now because there's nothing going on for my son, you know? Mm-hmm. And so the fact that you're coming up with these great programs that you're starting again, they're really going to help a lot of families, a lot of families. So when are these programs starting?
So the financial literacy, along with the financial literacy, we're actually going to do a communications course also, where, and that'll be right at the site. But all those plan to release all of those in the summer. And, you know, I want to make an announcement that we're releasing them in the summer because the plan is, and maybe in April, we will have our own facility.
Oh, wow. So congratulations.
Talented will have its own building.
Wow.
You can go to, and it'll be gym there. You can do, or we'll do our training there. We'll do our seminars there. Everything will be under one roof, and we won't be going to 4 different sites like we are now.
Good for you. That's great news.
So I'm just waiting an approval through, you know, zoning and stuff like that, the town, the city and stuff like that. But the plan is that, yeah, Talented will have its own building come April.
Do you want to tell us what city it will be in, or?
It'll be in, hopefully, fingers crossed, it'll be in New Britain.
Okay, great. So, it's great.
So Mayor Stewart, I need you right now, you know.
Yeah, shout out to Aaron over there. So you know, as far as your basketball program, so they're starting this month, correct?
Yes. So AAU, the season officially kicks off in March.
Okay.
I met with all of my other coaches last night, and we actually did the schedule for the season.
Okay.
And we've actually included season. We have a plan, and this is what I mean by being flexible. We have a plan A and we have a plan B, you know. Plan A is if the governor allows us, his next decision where he, you know, is January 19th. And the hope is that, you know, he will release the restrictions on youth sports and allow more kids on the court. You know, as long as we wear masks and stuff like that, that he'll lift that ban that he has right now. And we are going to offer an extended season, actually, that goes from January to July.
Oh, that's great.
You know, to hopefully to be able to catch up, you know, kids that missed the winter season. And, you know, if they don't move forward with a high school season and stuff like that, it'll be able to allow them to get, you know, a lot more gameplay. And, you know, we just want to be able to give kids an opportunity, you know, like we feel like they missed a lot.
Yeah.
You know, so that will, great, you know, unravel January 9th. We'll begin that the following week after the January 19th announcement. But if he does put a ban on, we'll just push it back, you know, until he's willing to release it. And we have, you know, our tournaments already scheduled and, you know, ideas of where we want to go.
Okay. Well, that's great. So I know that for the Talented, they're always looking for donations. And how can we make a donation to For the Talented? And also just want to bring up the fact that there also is a For the Talented clothing line that Hawk has created and developed along with his partners. And that's also just a great, I mean, just amazing clothing line, just cute, comfy clothes for kids and adults. So just mention that as well.
Yep. We just read. So to donate, you just want to go to fordatalentedsports.com. Scroll to the bottom. It's a big donate button on there. You can click right there and donate right on the website. Or, you can send me an email, fordatalentedsports.com, fordatalentedsports@gmail. Everything is for the talented sports. You can DM me on Instagram or whatever. And we're full 501c3 nonprofit, so we able to offer tax write-offs to for people who donate and everything. So you'll be able to write it off on your taxes. It is tax season, but unfortunately you missed the deadline. It'll go into 2021.
That's all right.
But we are able to offer that benefit to you. So we need money, with
Yeah.
this new
Got to keep these
facility.
programs going for these kids. It's just so important, you know?
Definitely.
And of course, money will create more programs for kids, which of course we have to just, these, the kids, right now with everything that's going on with COVID, and I know you have two small boys too there, Hawk. This, the effects of this will last a while with these kids. So I just feel like if we just keep them busy, keep them doing physical activity and keep challenging them in different ways, I think that, it will definitely really help with the process of recovering from this.
And you talk about the merchandise. The merchandise is actually something that I don't take a I don't take money from. The merchandise I actually put into the nonprofit program to be able to help those kids, So, and this past winter we released Jackson, who's our mascot for the clothing,
So cute.
Labrador, and we're actually within the next week we're going to release the new version of Jackson. Which is the talented music portion.
Oh.
Is actually, we wanted to highlight like the talented DJs and musicians out there. So you'll see Jackson as a DJ and a
Nice.
musician. So like we're beginning to release these different characters and show his personality, so that's exciting too, and it all goes with the overall brand, I never wanted my company to be in a box.
Right.
I never wanted us to say, well, you're a clothing company. You're a sports company. Like I never wanted it to necessarily be in a box. I just wanted it to be able to bring these, I had all these different skills and I wanted to be able to bring these different services to the community, right? So when people like say, oh, he's like a sports company, he's like, Connecticut Basketball Club, where he's like Connecticut Elite. I'm like, no, we're not. Like, we don't compare ourselves to like those companies. You may, but we actually try and operate under like
One umbrella, and
the
you kind of
idea of
classify.
like a Disney, where
Yeah.
we can have all of these different things under one roof. Like,
Right.
nobody says because you sell clothes, you can't do sports. Like, there's no
Right.
rule about it, like.
It's all fused into one, and it's all working together to raise funds for these kids, and that's all that matters. So,
That's it.
and
That's it.
for the talented clothing, you can go to at for the talented clothing on IG, and you can check out everything that they got going on their page and DM Hawk to get the clothes. The reason why I know all that is because we love the clothes in our households. Okay, thanks so much, Hawk. And again, just please give us your website so we can sign up for these programs.
It's for the talented sports.com. You'll begin to see a lot of the new stuff start to come up on the site within the next month. We're constantly updating the site, putting new material up there, and like I said, at for the talented, sports and clothing on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter and all of that stuff. So,
Well, thank
I
you so
really appreciate
much.
it. I really appreciate you guys, having me on.
Oh, Hawk, we love you.
I know we're good friends, but I know we're friends,
We're
right?
friends, but you're doing something
But
really great for the community, so we have to highlight that, Hawk.
Yeah,
I appreciate
absolutely.
that, like, 'cause that's not something that we do it for,
Right.